Welcome student to the maths class for class 7 lesson number 3 decimals part 2. Today I will explain how we can do the multiplication and division of decimal numbers. First rule, when we have to multiply a decimal number with 10, 100 or 1000, we have to shift the decimal towards right side one digit when we multiply it by 10. Here the decimal number is 42.912 multiplied by 10. So the answer is 429.12. The decimal moved towards right side one place. Similarly, when we multiplied by 100, the decimal has to move right side two digits. So the answer is, and when we multiply it by 1000, the decimal has to move towards right side 3 digits. 1, 2, 3. Second rule, when we have to multiply a decimal number with a whole number, students, first we have to do the simple multiplication. 45.245 multiplied by 53. First we multiply the number by 3, then we put the sign of cross under the first digit and when we have to multiply it by 5. After doing the multiplication, we do the addition. This is the simple multiplication. After doing the multiplication, we have to count the decimal places of the multipliant. So here are 3 decimal places, 1, 2, 3. With the answer or in the answer, we have to count the decimal places from the right side 3 and we have to put the decimal, 1, 2, 3. After 3 digits, we have to put the decimal. This is the answer of the multiplication of 45.245 with 53. So only you have to check that how many decimal places are after the decimal in the multiplier, we have to apply same in the answer. Third rule, when we have to multiply a decimal by a decimal number. Here also, first we have to do the simple multiplication as we done in the previous one. Only one thing you have to do, that you have to count the decimal places of multiplier and multipliant. Here are 3 digits, so 3, and here are 2 digits, 2. 3 plus 2, 5. In the answer, counting from the right side, after 5 digits we have to put the decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After 5 digits we have to put the decimal. So again once I am repeating that we have to count the decimal places of multiplier and multipliant both, then we do the sum of the decimal places, and in the answer we have to count that many places from the right side and we have to put the decimal. Now I will explain how we can do the division of decimal numbers. Students, when we have to divide a decimal number by 10, 100 or 1000, the decimal has to move towards left side one time when we divide by 10. So the answer will be 7.8372. When we divide by 100, the decimal has to move two digits towards the left side. So answer will be 9.1634. When we have to divide by 1000, decimal has to move 3 digits towards the left side. So 8.163912 is the answer. The second rule is division of decimal number by a whole number. Here we have to arrange the numbers in a column method and we have to do the simple division. First we divide 167 by 23 for 7 times. It comes 161. After doing the subtraction, 6 remain. Now I have to take this one for division, but before this one there is a decimal, so we have to put the decimal in the quotient also. After that we will take 1 for the division. Now we will multiply 23 2 times and answer will be 46. After doing subtraction, 15 remain. Now we will take this 8 for division and we multiply 23 6 times and we get 138. Now after doing the subtraction, 20 remain. Now we will take this 7 for division and we multiply 23 by 9 and we get 207 and the remainder will be 0. Only one thing you have to remember, students, when you have to take the digit next to the decimal for division, you have to put the decimal in the quotient also. The third rule is when we have to do the division of a decimal number by another decimal number. Student, here you have to remember one thing, that we cannot perform any kind of division if there is a decimal in divisor. So to remove this decimal from the divisor, first we arrange them in a fractional form. Now, to remove the decimal from the divisor, we have to multiply the divisor by 10 because there is only one digit after the decimal. When we multiply divisor by 10, we have to multiply dividend also by 10. When we multiply dividend by 10, the decimal has to move one digit towards the right. So 196.938, and this decimal removed from the divisor. Now after that, we have to do the same, we have to follow the same method as we done in the previous one. One more example I will explain to you, student. Here also the problem is same. There is a decimal in the divisor. If there is a decimal in the divisor, we cannot do any division. So first we arrange them in a fractional form, then we have to remove the decimal from the divisor. Here two digits are there after the decimal, so this divisor should multiply it by 100. So we have to multiply dividend also by 100. Now when we multiply, the decimal has to move two digit towards the right. And here also the decimal has to move two digit right and decimal removed from the divisor. After that, we have to do the simple division as we done in the previous rule.